We're preparing to go and talk to two black supremacists. They're people who believe that white people will not go to heaven. We're here to say that Jesus loves everybody.
In fact, we've got a still picture of me being pushed by three people.
Whoa, whoa!
They pushed Elder Broadhead. It was like they were pushing me. And that's when I had it. So I went over and listened to them for a minute, and they were using curse words that hurt my ears. And then I proceeded to say some things. The guy proceeded to tell me to shut up.
Roberts is sitting there just screaming at him. This guy's screaming back, calling him a dumb-dumb.
They call us all sorts of names. I was called dumb-dumb. Hinkle was a homosexual. Elder Jones was a faggot.
They're calling us homosexuals faggots. Now,
dumb dumb.
He's like, no,
they called us faggots, homosexuals, dumb dumbs.
And they called us damned devils.
Yeah, damned devils.
Devils, man. That was your carbon.
We don't need to cuss, guys.
That's what y'all are.
Guys, you don't need to cuss.
Devils.
And I love dumb dumb the best.
Dumb dumb.
We didn't call you guys any names. Yet you called us names.
Hold on. Wait.
Sounds kind of similar to what the Sadducees and Pharisees told Jesus Christ.
And then I said, that's what you're doing, because you're from the devil.
The fruits of the Spirit are love, joy, peace, temperance.
Let's get it. Let's prove that the Christ was a black man found out the Bible.
Jesus Christ was awesome.
We're going to show you a lie. You're a lie. We're going to prove out the Bible that Christ was a black man.
And then he started to raise his voice to me. And I wasn't scared. And I wanted to punch him in the face, but instead, I just asked him why skin color matters.
Starts reading scriptures that supposedly is supposed to prove that God is black, and as he reads them, he says his hair is white.
His head and his hair.
The place's head
white.
And his hairs.
White.
His head white. And his hair were white like wool.
And I say, well, there you have it. White. His hair is white.
No. White. White.
Wool.
White.
Wool.
White.
Wool.
His
white.
Head and his
wool.
Hair. His head and his hair.
And I'll tell you the best part. I was watching. Watching Burkell, he's screaming, yo, he's white, he's white.
And his
this
eyes
good's gonna come
was
with
a flame of fire.
And his eyes was a flame of fire.
Fire.
His eyes was red.
Fire.
His head and his hairs were white like
the guy
wool.
Tried to, I, his head, the thing
white
is,
like wool.
Listen, if you're learning, listen, it's an art. You can't talk and listen at the same time, dumb-dumb. He shall be red with white. Christ's eyes was red because he drank wine.
I don't know how many members of the church.
He was telling me it was my fault that my ancestors had beat his ancestors.
Their own skin color folks, the Negroes, turned against them and said, God is here to save everybody.
He should kick your mind shots, but we're teaching the word of God. That's what your problem is. Check this out. Where's that slave you signed at? Where's that slave? Where was your mouth in this, sis? Where was your mouth when this was going on, huh?
Stop.
You said Christ is white. Look, man, stop talking so you feel the scriptures, man.
No, that matters. What is that?
We're talking about
atonement.
Here we go. Alright, so everybody believe that this is Christ's way or this gate. Go ahead.
No. Because atonement doesn't make any difference regardless of what skin color you was.
What are you talking
about? You're a liar. You're a liar. Just think.
So that's when I brought up the point that God doesn't just love black people, he doesn't just love white people. God so loved the world that he sent his only begotten son. Whether you're black, whether you're white, whether you're green or purple with polka dots. That is what I believe.
I think we did the right thing today.
Crosby's sauce and a lot of other people's sauce,
yes,
alright?
I know.
Nobody says a word about this.